Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. The font family CSS property specifies the font for an element in HTML. It can hold several font names as fallback and one generic family. If the browser does not support or find the first font in font family, it tries the next font in font family. That is the whole idea behind specifying font family. Font family has got multiple fonts in it. Font family names are of two types: font family name, the name of the font family, like the main font, for example Arial or Verdana. And the generic family name, like serif, sans serif, cursive, fantasy, monospace. So here is how we can use font. This is HTML page. Linked with it is custom.css style sheet file. And this should be the output. This is our CSS file, font size 22 pixels. Font 22 pixels, Arial, sans serif. Okay, so this is font. And that was shorthand declaration of a font. Here is how you can use font family. Font family Verdana, Geneva, sans serif. So Verdana is a font, Geneva is a font, sans serif is a font or font category or generic font. We start with the font we want, in this case Verdana, and end with a generic family. Sans serif here is a generic family, kind of category of font. Generic family is to let the browser pick a similar font in the generic family if no other fonts are available. Like if this font is not available, browser will pick this font. And if this font does not exist in the system, then browser will pick a similar font in the generic family, in this category. For more clarity on it, consider this. this is your font, and this is a fallback font. And this is a generic family. Or fallback font, second fallback font, and generic family. This is how we declare a font family and name multiple fonts in it as fallback fonts. And there are different generic fonts or categories of fonts for different type of fonts. Let me give you an example from Google Fonts. These are Google Fonts, and from here you can see the categories. I mean, this is Roboto font, this is Noto Sans JP, this is Open Sans, and here are categories. So in the categories you can see serif, sans serif, display, handwriting, monospace. So if I choose serif, you can see fonts with the type of serif or category of serif. And then this is sans serif. And these are display. And then we have got handwriting font. And we have got monospace. These are the type of fonts. Usually serif and sans serif are used in most cases. To give you more clarity on this, I have got a list here. As you can see, this font family that has got Arial has got category or generic family as sans serif. Similar for Verdana, sans serif. Helvetica, sans serif. Tahuma, sans serif. And then we have got font family Time New Roman, and we have got generic family for it as serif. And serif is for Georgia, serif is for this font. And then for Courier New, we have got monospace as font category or generic family. And then we have got this font that has got cursive as font category. So these fonts fall under category of sans serif, and these fonts fall under category or generic family of serif. It is best to use appropriate category or generic family for each font, and also you can use as many fonts as fallback fonts as much as you like. So this was the structure of a font family and how to choose or use font family. And from here, if I select Roboto and then I select this style from here, you will see this font family Roboto and then sans serif generic family. So I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything, comment down below. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to this channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.